For decades, we have been shrinking and shrinking transistors, and now we are going below 1 nanometer scale, and we are actually getting closer and closer to what we call technology limit. So, what is next? In order to scale the integration further, we have to go away from traditional monolithic planar designs. And it is really, really hot topic in the industry now. And at the moment, it is crystal clear that the future chips are gonna be 3D. Building 3D chips, so stacking chips horizontally and vertically, is a really prominent technology, which will make possible another step up in performance and expanding the Moore's law. Companies like Intel, TSMC, AMD, and Samsung are betting on this technology as the main driver of the high-performance compute future. In order to scale the integration further, we have to integrate blocks vertically, and it kind of makes sense. You know, in the modern computers, one of the key bottlenecks is the access to memory. In order to solve this bottleneck in 3D technologies, the memory is placed right on the top of CPU and GPU. In this way, both CPU and GPU can access the memory simultaneously with minimum interconnect and thus lowest latencies. Another typical aspect, let's say we have an issue with power integrity, then let's just deliver the power vertically. It's like it's done in Dojo. This is the key concept behind the future 3D chips. This technology is not something futuristic. Intel is already fabricating their first prototypes of 14th generation Meteor Lake chips using this 3D technology. This chip will use both Intel 4 technology for the CPU and TSMC technology as well. I mean, overall, TSMC made an impressive progress in the 3D packaging technology. They've actually developed different flavors of this 3D technology. The first technology is called SoIC. It is kind of like SoC, but it is 3D multi-chip integration technologies, which is called System on Integrated Chip. We all know that building SoCs is a new prestige nowadays, integrating CPUs, GPU, NPU, and memory in one chip. Well, System on Integrated Chip is actually one step ahead. This 3D chip concept is also known as chiplets. If we think of a traditional, typical SoC, it can be partitioned into different chiplets with different logic functionality and also memory chiplets. So with this technology, you can integrate chiplets with different die size, different functionality, and also even fabricated in different technology nodes, and all into one chip. Basically here, you can mix and match blocks from different technology nodes. For instance, take some blocks fabricated in larger technology nodes because they're definitely cheaper, or even reuse old blocks which don't scale that well, for instance, analog blocks or RF blocks. So this is the beauty of it. But from outside, these 3D chips looks exactly like a typical SoC, but you get better performance and faster time to market. And there is actually another advantage of separating components into smaller chiplets to improve the yield on the wafer. And for this technology, TSMC introduced new bonding with smaller bonding pitch and higher bump density, which allows to bring the chiplets even closer together and allow faster and shorter interconnect. The key reasons to use this technology is to enable more memory and higher bandwidth with stacked memory, and improved power delivery with deep trench capacitors for high power applications. And then TSMC introduced another 3D technology, which is called WoW, basically wafer on wafer. So they can stack one wafer on top of another wafer, and this is really mind-blowing. Here they've achieved tight bonding pitch and thin through silicon vias, so TSV, so minimum parasitic for lower power and latency as well as smaller form factor. This technology is a choice for high-yield nodes only and for the same die size designs. It even supports using the third-party wafer, so for instance a wafer coming from Intel. Then there is my absolute favorite 3D packaging technology by TSMC, integrated fan-out system-on-wafer technology. I've already covered it in my channel in the context of Dojo supercomputer. This is how InfoSOV system looks like. So the advantage of this system-on-wafer technology that it allows power integration directly on the wafer. In such a system, power, thermal and mechanical are all interfacing directly with the chips. It basically allows to connect multiple chips and power and directly attach them to the heat dissipation modules using routing distribution technology. Packing multiple chips arrays together has benefits such as low latency, so fast chip-to-chip communication, and also low impedance. Low impedance means stable power delivery and low power loss. And this technology was also used for Cherry Brass split system on wafer, which, you know, a super huge chip of a size of a wafer. This technology is especially beneficial for AI chips or high performance compute chips because these chips have huge power dissipation. So it requires really decent cooling, and TSMC InfoSOV, so integrated fan-out system on wafer technology, is a solution to this. Also, AMD was working with TSMC to create 3D chiplet packaging technology. And the first application of this technology is a 3D vertical cache. They call it 3D V cache. Here is how it looks like. They took AMD Ryzen 5900X processor and stacked 64 megabytes of SRAM directly on top of it. They thinned the 3D cache die and added structural silicon to create a seamless surface. In this way, they've tripled the amount of high-speed S3 cache. Larger cache is important in many workloads. You know, games become much faster when you bring memory closer to processor, so to GPU. The die-to-die interface uses a direct copper-to-copper bond with no solder bumps. Using this hybrid bond approach using TSV, so through silicon vias, they've achieved over 200 times the interconnect density in comparison to the planar 2D chips. This enables a much more efficient and denser integration of IPs, so of sublocks. When they compare M-Analytic Ryzen 5900X with a 3D chiplet version of it, they've achieved about 12% performance improvements on average. But this was just a prototype, and AMD is starting to fabricate new chips in this new 3D chiplet technology already this year. AMD will be using chiplet technology for the next Zen 4D Ryzen CPU, and I expect significant performance gains there. Not only TSMC and AMD, but also Intel has 3D microchip technology on their roadmap. But Intel has a different approach here. They're using tile approach. And the idea of tiles is again to improve the bandwidth, to reduce the latency and also to reduce the power loss. They want to be able to integrate together tiles coming from different technology nodes, and they want to bring them together on a single chip. And so basically they want to move from system on chip to a system on package. And the key difference to AMD that Intel uses their own MIP interconnect technology and Foveros stacking technology. And this is something which Intel developed internally. So tiles are interconnected using Intel's EMIP, embedded multi-die interconnect bridge technology. It is essentially micro bumps at a much higher density than you would find it on a standard packaging substrate. Micro bumps are tiny balls of solder which form a high density bridge connecting one tile to another, which allows them to communicate with each other and to share resources. And this is in order to be able to increase the core counts, like size of cache, memory, and IOS. And for stacking of chiplets, they've introduced Foveros technology. This is basically logic-on-logic die stacking, but instead of horizontal stacking, it is a vertical one. They first used it for Lakefeld chip. This type of integration allows you to get extremely high bandwidth between the two chiplets. But it is based on internal interfaces. So basically these two dies have to be co-designed together because they have to be floor planned together in order to manage the power delivery. Again, Intel can mix and match tiles from different process nodes and also even from different manufacturers, and then use MIP interconnect and Foveros technology to build the chiplet itself. And as a result, they get a smaller form factor and improved performance. Intel is using this 3D chiplet technology in their Aurora supercomputer, which is basically a GPU accelerator located at Argonne National Lab. Here, they use Sapphire Rapid CPU combined with new Ponte Vecchio HPC-based GPU accelerator. Each unit of Aurora features two Intel newest Sapphire Rapid CPUs featuring four compute tiles, DDR5, PCIe 5.0, and so on. And they will be using EMIB and Foveros connectivity between the tiles. It is a working example of Intel's tile design. It is constructed out of more than 47 tiles and rolling in at over 100 billion transistors. There is no question that future is gonna be chiplet-based, so 3D. I think more and more products from Intel, AMD, Nvidia, and Samsung will be chiplet-based. And you know, the chip fabrication at the state-of-the-art nodes, like 3-nanometer nodes, is extremely expensive. This technology will make possible to reuse some of the old blocks which are fabricated in larger technology nodes, so which are cheaper. Also, there are many advantages of separating components into smaller blocks, so smaller chiplets, to improve the yield on each wafer. One of the key applications is to stack the memory vertically. This enables you to pack more memory and to get a higher bandwidth. Anyway, there is still room for monolithic traditional designs because they are simply cheaper and easier to implement. I hope you enjoyed this video and my winter Christmas mood deco on the background. Now you may like to check out another of my video where I explain the state-of-the-art transistor technology. So 1-nanometer and 2-nanometer transistors, which just were developed this year. I will link it here. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next week in my next video. Ciao!